Last couple of months have been a little bit crazy for me, at least on my YouTube channel. We grew 1,000 subscribers, like, in a couple of months, which is insane for me. I wouldn't ever expect that to happen. And if I look back into my stats, it looks like everything kinda happened in March. And you know, guys, what happened around that time? Quarantine. Before I begin, I want to say that I also stream on Twitch on Tuesdays and Fridays, 8 PM Central European Time on twitch.tv/3. If you do speak Dutch, I also stream on Mondays and Wednesdays on twitch.tv/goedgemutst. If you don't speak Dutch, don't go there because it will all be in Dutch, but in truly everything is in English, so feel free to hop in there and ask any questions about streaming. So I have been making videos on this channel for quite a while, I don't know exactly. I guess I can look back and see how long I've been making videos on this channel. Let's see, organize them on date. Officially, my oldest video is from 2012, but that's actually just a fan video of me. I used to love Dutch music and I used to just go everywhere, and it was a video of me being on stage with like a Dutch singer. You can't actually view it anymore, guys, so don't try and find it. But the actual first tree video on this channel was in 2017. 3 November 2017 to be exact. And it's a video called Halloween Stream. It's not available right now, I unlisted it, because I'm kind of ashamed of it. What this video was basically a highlight video of my Halloween stream, which might already be clear if you know the title, right? I'm going into the analytics of this video real quick to just see how many views it has. It doesn't say anymore. Ah, darn. Apparently it doesn't say it anymore if you set it on unlisted, but apparently had 21% audio retention, which is not that bad, to be honest, but yeah, we can't see any sets of it anymore. That's a shame. But after that, I started to make a lot of videos about indie games, and I made, like, I don't know, maybe 100. I made a lot, okay? And none of them really took off, and not a lot of things happened there, and I was actually pretty sure that this YouTube channel was just gonna fail. Yeah, that was, like, what I thought it was going to be. And then here, on the 3rd of August 2018, I released a video which was called Streamlabs Chatbot Tutorial. You guys might have seen it, that might be the reason why you're here right now. But that video I made because a lot of people were asking me, Tree, how does Streamlabs Chatbot work? And a lot of people had trouble with how to set it up for their stream. And I used to just sit in a Discord call with those people and just have this screen share on and talk them through everything for like 30 minutes. And it was just such a pain because so many people kept coming to me to ask me, like, how does it work, Tree? That I started to spend a lot of time in my week explaining this program to people. So what I decided to do is I decided to just make a YouTube video, because then I could just show them that video and then they could ask questions afterwards if they still had questions. Usually they didn't, so I guess it was a good video. What happened was, because those people watched the whole video and it was 30 minutes long, YouTube started to pick this up. YouTube started to see that it was a good, helpful video. And right now, at this moment, which is on Sunday, just before this video gets released, I record my videos on Sunday, then I can edit them, and then they can go live on Wednesday, you know? So, right now, it has 36,869 views. That's insane to me, guys. Thank you so much for everybody who watched that video. But that's, like, super insane to me. And I'm still super grateful, and I'm just happy that I could help so many people. Like, imagine 36k people. Like, how many people is that? I can't even imagine how many people that is. I helped those people set up this program, and I'm just so happy that I could do that. It was just never possible if I kept going the same way I used to do it. I just sit in the Discord call with them and I explain the program. That wouldn't be possible with 36k people. Like, even if I did this every single minute of the day, I would not have helped as many people as I did right now. So because of that, I became really passionate about explaining things I knew about Twitch. I really want to explain all the programs, everything that has to do with Twitch, and I haven't done that yet because there's so much to explain. There's so much more to explain, so a lot more videos are coming, and don't worry guys, I will not be gone for a while because there's just too much to explain, okay? So what I started to do is I started to, next to the gameplay videos, also started to talk about programs for streamers. More of those videos started to be picked up by the algorithm, more of those videos recommended to streamers because they really wanted to fix their stuff. They wanted to set up apps. They wanted to make their stream look good, right? Like, probably like you and me, because I like to do that myself as well. And the gameplay videos still weren't that's successful. So what I did is I unlisted all the gameplay videos, sorry, for everybody who liked them. Except for the Bioshock one, because everybody seems to like the Bioshock one, and I'm kind of sad if people are gonna like, miss out on that one. I really liked playing it, and just I feel sad to unlist those. Does that make sense? I don't know if that makes sense, but for me it does. So to come back to the fact that my YouTube channel kind of blew up during quarantine, is if we go back to my stats, like my analytics of the whole channel. What happened here? Friday the 17th. I think there's just no data on that day because it is a weirdly gap of zero views. I don't think that would be right. But you can see my stats for the last 28 days. I'm not gonna hide anything. You might think it is a lot, you might think it's not a lot, depending on like what your perspective is. If you just started a YouTube channel and you look at these, you're like, oh my god, that's insane to me. If you compare me to people that have a million subscribers, this is nothing, of course, but for people that just start out, this is insane. If you have your own YouTube channel, you probably know that it is insane. So right here it says, viewers are up. Your channel got 37k views, well, almost 38. In the last 28 days, and it says normally it's 13 to 21k, which is a lot more views than normally. That is insane, right? If we scroll down here, we can also see which videos took off, and there's actually quite a lot that just got over 1,000 views this month, which, like, every video that gets over 1,000 views just in total, that is a success for me. That's like a good video, like, for me that's something that blew up, right? And these are videos that get 1,000 views this month, even though some of them didn't come out this month. But what I want to do is set this on 365 days so you guys can see the actual growth. Again, there's this weird spike here to the bottom. I'm guessing that's the same day where there's no data available. YouTube, I don't know what happened there. And you can see exactly what my stats were the last 365 days, so the last year. Right here, we can see my revenue. And if you look at this and you think 450, that's a lot, just try and think about the amount of videos I have released in the last year. One video takes about 5 hours on average for me. It's not a great cost per hour. Working in the supermarket will pay you more, but it's also the passion that counts, right guys? I do it to help you guys, not to make the big bucks. You can see that in the last year we got 1.9k subscribers, 8.2k watch hours, and 250k views. And if you see this is kind of steady growth. We've got like goes up a little bit, but here this is insane. Look at that, that goes a lot faster than it used to. Here, this is March, this is April, May, June, July. This is the period of the quarantine, guys. This is where everybody started to sit at home. This is where people probably started to stream on Twitch more because they wanted to fill in their free time with something else than going to pubs and to just going to adventure parks and stuff like that. What I think happened is there's a combination of people that try to make money with either streaming or YouTube, just with content creation in general, and a combination with people that trying to spend their free time and they want to know how to set up their Twitch. Maybe this is also just a trend on YouTube where a lot of channels blow up because a lot of people have more free time to watch YouTube. But for me, this is insane. This is insane. Like here, right now, we have 1,500 views a day. Where here, it was just 250. Just 250. And that's insane to me. That's just half a year ago, right? Especially if you look at watch time. This is how much time people spent watching videos. You can see this is just going up a lot more than here. There's some spikes here because some of the videos came out that were doing a lot better. This video with how to talk to yourself when nobody's watching your stream. It's a little bit different title, but something like that. That one was a really good video for me, and you see this spike here because a lot of people watched the whole video through. But other than that, it was kind of steady, but here it's so much more. It's so much more. And with the revenue too, like, this is steady increase of revenue, but here, look at these spikes. This is just insane. This is per day. This is revenue per day. Boom. And what I want to look at with you guys is my reach, impressions. 1.9 million people saw my video thumbnail and title. I don't know, that's so many people. And then if we scroll down, we can see how I got those views. And for those of you who want to start a YouTube channel or that already have started a YouTube channel, this might be good information to know. How do I get my views? So here we see Traffic sources. YouTube search is 50%. 50% just comes from typing something in like Streamlabs chatbot and then finds my video, clicks on it, and goes to watch it. And then we have 31% from external. Well, underneath here it says traffic sources external, which explains where they come from. And 80% comes from Google search, which means that people search something like Streamlabs chatbot in Google and find my video. Almost all of the external comes from Google search. The other ones is mostly like Twitter and Blurb. Blurb is like an extension and they put my video on their website, so that's probably why some people came from there. And Twitter is just me promoting my own video. So we can say that about 80% of my views just come from people that search a video and I rank on those searches. You can see these stats from every individual video, and you can even see which videos brought you the most views, which videos have the highest click-through rate, the most watch time and everything like that. But this video is going to be way too long if I'm looking into that. I just want to let you guys know that the channel is kind of popping off right now with the quarantine going on and everybody starts watching it, and I really just appreciate that. And I wanted to make this video to just be open with you guys about how it goes with this channel, and I think it's just good to be genuine with you guys, and this is just my way of doing it. Just showing you guys the inside of the channel and how we're doing right now. I wanted to also take a look at the audience tab here. If we scroll down, we can see that a lot of people that watch my videos, 91%, are not subscribed yet. If you're one of those people and watching my videos, go subscribe right now. The reason behind this might be because a lot of my videos solve a problem. And because they solve one problem for a person, they might not think to look further on my channel to see that I solve more problems for them. There's so much more videos that can help them solve problems regarding streaming. What they do is they don't know how to set something up, they Google it, they watch my video, they found out how, and they just go on with their life. And lately I'm trying to fix it a little bit by recommending videos in a video that are connected to the other video. This might be a bit confusing, but I would say something like, if you guys don't know what to say on stream, I've got a video about how to talk to yourself when nobody's watching right in the card above. So that's kind of how I connect my videos together, because if you watch this video, you will probably also want to watch this video. It's not like pushing them to watch videos, it's just trying to recommend them something that can help them too, right? I've been doing that more lately, and I hope that this subscribe-unsubscribe ratio will go differently, so more people will subscribe instead of not subscribing. On the other hand, this is really good news. If 91% of you people that watch my videos haven't subscribed yet, this means that there's so much more people that can subscribe to my channel and watch all the videos. There's just so much more growth possible for my channel, because those people are already watching my videos anyway. So most of my views actually come from Google search or YouTube search. And I want to explain more about how to rank for search in Google and YouTube. But I want you guys to want this. I don't want to make videos that you guys don't want to see. So if you want to see a video where I explain how to rank in Google and in YouTube search, just type search in the comments. Are you a streamer and you don't know anything about YouTube yet and you're thinking about starting one? I've got a playlist for streamers, how to start a YouTube channel and where to make it about. You find it right here, right now, and I will see you there.